My name is Madison Story, and I'm a senior here in the ZooSide program at West Liberty University, and today I'm going to show you what it's like to be a student here. And now we're heading into animal behavior class. So we left off talking about classical conditioning. What's common in classical conditioning, and that's useful to us, is the idea of external inhibition. West Liberty Zoo Science Program, it is one of the few universities in the country that offers a zoo science program. It's really unique in the aspect of not only do we have the on-site animals in our labs to work with, we have a larger collection of animals compared to most of those other programs, and we definitely have the largest or one of the largest reptile collections with a diverse amount of species that you really wouldn't get to work with at a different program or even sometimes in zoos. It's super cool being able to sit in a classroom and like take our herpetology lecture and have those different reptile species be in the room with us. And it really drives home the point or helps students learn when you're learning about a species and you can have the species right next to you, and it definitely helps the learning experience. Now we're heading into field biology lecture.
You've got your quadrat. You're going to calculate the total area of your quadrat. It's each side is a half meter.
So the way the program is set up, your freshman and sophomore year are spent mostly taking your entry-level zoo or just animal behavior courses, basic animal husbandry courses. And then after your sophomore year, you get to decide whether or not you want to stick more towards the zoo animal management track or go more the applied con route. And there's a couple classes that are different in between the two. With the applied con route, it focuses more on getting you experience in the field. You get to work a lot more directly with Dr. Loafman's crayfish lab. And instead of requiring you to do zoo internships to graduate, it requires you to get field experience, either with the crayfish lab or a different lab. And now we're at the Ogilvy Good Zoo for our animal behavior lab.
Who do you want to do, and then I'll just drag you up?
I can do Poe. I don't think he'll like step up, here. But. West Liberty Zoo Science Program has a really unique relationship with the Ogilvy Good Zoo. It's the only AZA accredited zoo in West Virginia, and it's very unique having the director of a zoo also be a professor at the university. Very rarely do you get to interact with a director, let alone have them teaching your classes. So during your freshman, sophomore year here, the goal is to work with the animals in the labs here on campus. And then after you get about 200 hours working with the animals here, you're able to do internships during the semester or just work at the Ogilvy Good Zoo and get that experience with endangered species, more large mammals that we couldn't have on campus through an AZA zoo. Catch crayfish. The field biology course is one of the required courses for both the zoo side track and the applied conservation track. It's a great chance to get everyone some field experience. This semester I am in a group that is helping the new postdoc in the crayfish lab, and we are sampling the creeks around Wheeling. We're taking measurements and looking at sexual dimorphism in two species of crayfish. So I chose this program mostly because West Liberty is a little bit closer to home for me, but far enough away from home that it's still a good college experience. Really, the reptile aspect brought me in. I knew going into this that I really enjoyed working with reptiles, but being able to get this hands-on experience with such a diverse collection has allowed me to gain confidence working with large animals that could be transferred to working with large mammals, large raptors, and not just large reptiles. My personal goals after leaving West Liberty is to go into wildlife rehabilitation, but taking the skills learned here from basic husbandry procedures, I can take that experience and use it to build upon for birds or mammals. Thank you for checking out our program today. For more information, just check out our website.